It is 5 o'clock in the morning. I have not been asleep. I've tried to go to sleep, lay there in the bed, but it's just not happening. So you know what? We're just going to work out. We're going to call this the no sleep workout.
Fresh.
When I was a little boy, I wanted to be a hero.
The truth is, when you get older, sometimes things don't always turn out the way you hoped they would. So you gotta do what you gotta do. Handle that business. Believe in yourself. Create your own destiny.
Everybody needs this. Adrenal reset. You need this bad boy. And then a tape. And no nitro. I like CBD Labs, CTD. I've been taking their stuff since I was like 19. That's when I found out about them. I think around 19 is when I started getting like serious about fitness. Talking about fat burners, I think this is the one I've used when I was competing. So I started trying it out again right here. Adrenal reset, it'll help you. It will help. I got food and stuff up here. I got some plant-based protein. I drink protein. This is it. But I've had this for like 2 months, right? So this is like gone. I've had these for 2 months, and I haven't even touched this yet. Like, it shows you. Like, I don't even mess with protein like that, bro. Also, where is it? I have a carb drink. So, EFX. I used to take Carbaline. So like for mornings where I don't feel like eating, I'll take that. I have two of them. That's EFX and then Evogen, which I like their products as well. That's really it. My multivitamins. Got my multivitamins right here. That's about it. I got some Celtec, but that was for Jeff. It's like this 5-in-1 post-workout creatine and BCA formula. This stuff right here. Muscle Tech is a company that I first started out with. My uncle had these pills from Muscle Tech. It was like creatine pills, these big fat creatine pills. And my first time having supplements was my senior year of high school. And it's because of my uncle. Because he had like a drawer just like this with his supplements and stuff in it. And he got me into like working out. I remember, you know, in high school, I was like, when I went to Merlin, so in high school, training in Texas, it was mandatory to work out. Gym was mandatory, daily. Every morning, every afternoon, whatever, on the daily. It was even mandatory in the summer. We had to train all year round. Now, when I moved to Merlin my senior year, which kind of messed up my like football career, training there wasn't necessary. They had a gym, but nobody used it. I was the only person, this is what I remember, I was the only person after school, you know, on weekends, whatever, at the school gym training, working out, and just, I mean, you know, of course, because, you know, because there's like girls there after school, and you just kind of walk around shirtless, you know what I'm saying, but I was the only one after school working out at the gym. I mean, which, it was me and Mwanza, where we were the strongest person, and Otha. Me, Mwanza, and Otha were the strongest people on the team. It was always between, like, Otha was strong. He had a strong bench. I always tried to get big like him. And he told me his secret was oatmeal and eggs. And I was like, you bull, you're a liar. But Otha was just, when you got a name like Otha, you just think somebody big. Like, Otha was a big boy. Mwanza was crazy. Like, if people think I'm like gifted, like, no, just do Mwanza. Check out now, type him in Google, Mwanza Wambalumba. Don't know how to spell this nigga name, but the most when you want a prime example of some black African genetics, Mwanza Wambalumba. Big, lean, big, strong. And fast. He was our defensive end at Fort Meade High School, and he went to play college ball. I'm not sure he got scholarship to play college ball. I'm not sure if he went to the NFL, but if he didn't, I don't know how. But that kid was ridiculous. I I looked out, I was like, damn, like, I came from Texas, and we already big down there. Going into Merlin, I looked at this dude like, yo, who this? I don't even know how to describe it. But anyways, let me stop talking. Supplement drawer. Pretty sure y'all were wanting to see what's in here. So we got the NO. It's a fat burner. I always try like different type of pre-works out. This one's kind of alright. It's not, you know, it's whatever. It's stupid strong. So I'm trying some pump stuff out. All my multivitamins. It was like buy one, get two free. So I was like, okay. Video.com. Carbs. I'm not sure. This is like some sample thing that I tried. It's like another pre-workout thingy. And then another pre-workout right here. Evogen, once again. Don't really care for that one. It's probably the worst one. I let Jeff use that. This one is like, this one I use when, I'm probably going to use this now because it helps me go to sleep after my workout because I crash stupid hard after this. So this isn't something I can't take during the day. Or I'm going to be lazy all day. And so, that's why I usually, if I know I'm going to take this that day, I take this at night. And I'll usually take one of these in the afternoon. So, but I'm probably going to take the other one instead of this one. And if I work out later today, I'm going to take G Fuel. Yo, I was so bored last night. I was making like almond sandwiches. We don't eat white bread. Babe gets like this seed bread. That we eat. It's like seed bread. I'm not gonna lie, I'm very excited. I mean, very not excited. I'm very pleased with California from New York. I wake up, birds chirping and shit, you know, sun smiling and shit, like on some bear in the big new house type of shit. And it's just, I just feel good. I'm relaxed out here. Like, I can be busy and relaxed at the same time, you know? I have so much space in this house. This house is like, double the size of my last place. Like my last place was just like from here on down, from here on out, that was my last place. Just the first floor, not even the full first floor, just like a portion of the first floor of this place. And we have two freaking floors. I feel like a freaking adult, you know? It feels good. And I still don't have furniture in here yet. We've been here for 3 months. I still have no furniture in like the living room area. Palin's friend just came by. She just stayed. And I mean, luckily we had this futon bed thingy. We got a TV right here, a table that I'm not even gonna keep. Still got, I wanna put a projector in here. I wanna put a projector in here. I wanna put a projector outside on the patio. That'd be cool. So, Michael Jackson, boy. Oh shit, nigga. Oh shit, nigga. You're gonna be so tired, you just be doing shit. My body's like, nigga, stop drinking shit. I got bags under my eyes, bro. Oh, shit, why am I tired? Hey, these hoes be popping. Right here. They're still not better than Aunt Jemima's, but for some protein and shit in it. All right, let's go.
If you ever want to get your ass whipped in Mario Tennis, holla at your guala. Alright, last thing. These are all the shoes. All my shoes. All my shoes.
Reebok.
These are my favorites. Right here. The Nano 8. Please do yourself a favor. Go to the link in the description of my Reebok link. Yes, my Reebok link. No code, but you can still buy these bad boys. We're going to wear them today. Nano 8s, once again. My favorite. I love these too. My casuals. the Fusion Flex Weave. These are fucking dope, bro. Got my boxing shoes. But I actually wear them, like, to the clubs and shit. Like, yo, what's them shoes? I'm like, man, these boxing shoes. Like, yo. Stunting the Gucci hat. Yeah, I'm stunting right now. Let me flex a little bit, bro. Let me flex. Alien shoes right here. My other Alien shoes down there. My lifters. My Yeezys. I'm gonna start collecting Yeezys because I like Kanye.
I'll be back.
Alright, let's go.
Started, I do about 3.5 miles per hour at an incline of 6, about 10 minutes warm up, just kind of get my mind right, beautiful view. You know, like lately I just kind of come in, unless I'm training with Joe, which he already has his set, you know, the 20, 15, 10, 10, the rep out, I guess like every other training day. But me, I just kind of come in here just like, you know, just to kind of feel what my body feels most of the time. You know, sometimes I come in here with a set plan, other times, like today, it's just kind of just freely going through, not flowing through a movement, because that means you're just kind of bullshit. Just going with feel, that's all we're doing. So we're gonna build that upper chest, build that chest strength, build that push strength. I'm not gonna say upper chest, I'm gonna just say push strength all together, because, you know, doing incline helps push more, you know, with shoulder press, bench press, pressing movements regardless. So we're gonna work on press strength and those upper pecs as well. Experiencing 315 for 4, which usually 6 reps will be easy for me. 4, obviously we're going to assume that it's the lack of sleep, but being able to still push 315 for 4, I'm fine with it. My chest is still feeling it. So we're going to do one more set of 315 for 4, and I'm going to do a drop set after that. Smith machine is because the regular decline can't adjust how decline you want it. We're pretty much at max decline right here, so I want that big stretch and those elbows come back to get that good feel of growth, that volume work, that hypertrophy, that pump. That's gonna be the key. And one thing about this is I can put on weight, massive amount of weight, maybe like 315, I can possibly rep it out for 10 reps on this. I got 225 on it now, let's see how it feels. After that, but if I feel good, you can pump up the volume and get it going. Next up, we're gonna move up to some tricep movements. We're gonna still use this Smith machine, and what we're gonna do is close hand tricep extensions. We're gonna go for high reps, 3 sets of 15 to 20 reps.
My name is Jeff.
It's Jefe, man.